What's going on, everybody? It is your man, Cleveland Terry, and today we're going to show you how to make your own intros and outros using Serato Studio. Let's go. Now, I know what you're saying. I'm in Record Pulse. I can just download the track that already has their own intros and outros included. And that is true. You can do that. But if you do them yourself, you can customize them to the way you DJ, especially rock music. There's a lot of rock tracks that have never had outros and intros, and maybe those Record Pulse don't have any intention of ever making them. So this is where you fall in, and using something like Serato Studio can get you there very, very easily, very efficiently, very fast. So before we get started, if you want to follow along or if this is something that you want to do in the future, drop down in the details below, click on that link to get yourself 2 free months of Serato Studio using my code Cleveland. That's right, it'll give you full access to Serato Studio for 2 whole months. Sound good to you? Sounds good to me. All right, guys, let's get into the app and let's see what we're talking about here. Okay, so the first thing that happens when you open up the app is you get the new remix and the new beat. For this one, we're going to go into new remix because we're not making our own new song. So let's head over to new remix and we are going to go and find a song. So the song we're going to use today is a classic song, which is called Here It Goes by OK Go. Now, once you click on it, it's going to automatically play the song just to make sure that's the one you want. But we're going to take the song and we're going to drag it right into this big drop audio box right here. Now, you don't actually need Serato DJ Pro or Recordbox or any of these other programs to make this program work. This works with everything because all you need to do is drag and drop from your desktop, from your downloads, from iTunes. They're all available to you. This is a completely open platform application. Now, if you are using Serato DJ, well, it makes it a little easier because it will show you all your crates right in Serato Studio. All right, now that we have the song in the player, it's now time to start editing it up the way we want to. Okay. All right, so we're gonna take that part right there and we're gonna use that as the beginning of our song. So let's set a cue point for there. All right, set a cue point just by pressing the number. All right, so that's going to be our intro beat. Now we're gonna take the verse part. So let's get that playing right here. Now that we have that, we need to create an outro. So the outro is going to be, I believe, right here. Yes, right here. Okay. The reason that I made that clip 4 is not because we're actually going to use this clip. This clip right here is just kind of identifying where I want the song to end. So we're actually going to just kind of remove everything after that part. And we're going to put our outro right there. So this is just a visual cue for me. All right, let's start dragging in our stuff. We don't need that at all. So we need this part right here. So let's, oh, we almost made one mistake here. Now, this is why. If you set a cue point and you don't set an out point, it's basically going to take the whole song. So we need to identify where the end of the loop is. So let's go over here. Let's increase the size of this guy so it's easier to see. And let's take a listen. Okay, there it is right there. So we have here 2 different arrows, an arrow pointing to the left and an arrow pointing to the right. We're going to take this arrow pointing to the right and we are going to drag it right there. That is going to be our loop. Now, here's the thing. Let's say that you did not do this thing yet, or let's say it was too long, right? You can actually adjust the loop on the fly. So let's take this down and just show you. Now, see how long that is? We can take that and we can bring it back and you can see the loop adjusted as we changed it. So now we're just gonna duplicate the loop. Sounds clean. Now we're going to take the verse, we're going to drag that right here. Make sure it's clean. Perfect. Now we're going to go to where we were talking about, where the clip ends, which is right here. Let's get rid of this real quick, now that I know where I'm going. All right, and we're going to do a Command E where we want to get rid of it. That's close enough. We'll do a Command E. We'll get rid of this guy just by hitting delete, and we don't need this guy anymore. So we'll get rid of that. Okay. Now, let's increase the size of this so we can see what's going on here, which is also Command Plus. Yes, Command Plus. Okay. All right, now we are going to take this, and we're going to take our intro, which is going to be our outro, and we're going to feed this guy right at the end of here. Okay, it's a little off, and because we're dealing with a rock song that's slightly not beat gridded exactly where we want it, we're just going to have to go ahead and make some manual adjustments here. Not a problem. Just a couple of little tweaks here and there. And let's move this here, like so. Okay. Perfect. All right, then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go ahead and, let's shrink this down so I can see what we're doing. We're just gonna go ahead and loop this to form our outro. All we need to do is to go ahead and export this out. So file, export song. We're going to save this as an MP3. You can save it either way. Export it out. Here it goes. Edit. Put your little name in there. It's yours. You made the edit yourself. Hit save. And in real time, just like that, the export is done. It is just that easy to make your own intros quick, efficiently, painlessly, which is the most important part. All right, guys, if you found what I said here useful, drop down in the description below, hit that download link, which will give you 2 free months of Serato Studio using my code. Hit that like button. If you found what I said here really useful, hit that subscribe button. Make sure you follow me on the Instagrams and the Twitters. Make sure you hit that notification bell so you get notified when I post a new video. This is part one of a 4-part series, so you want to make sure you are getting notified. Also, get in my Discord. My Discord is going to be the easiest way to know anything that I do is going to be listed in my Discord. Always a pleasure. If I don't talk to you later, we'll talk soon. Peace.